Good morning to you, listeners, viewers.
Good morning, Phillip. Well, give us a sense of how you thought yesterday went and in terms of your party's performance.
I think the party performed beautifully. I think the machinery of the party has grown in leaps and bounds in 3 weeks. You all would have seen that yourself. The public's response to the party, that has grown tremendously. We've used the local government election campaign to get ourselves into every nook and cranny of the country. We've done that. So now it's about building on that. I listened to your last guest. He said that the election is over, come out of campaign mode because it's not healthy. That is the most incorrect statement he could make. The campaign mode is the closest thing that the people of Trinidad and Tobago ever get to government responding and delivering goods and services. Your roads get paved, you get water, you get your tax refunds. A lot of stuff happened in the past 2 weeks that were not for election. Belmont, up the steps in Belmont, where the councillor Nicole Young, who was just successful again, she walks through a rubbish pile to get to her office, were not for a local government election. Progressive Empowerment Party, through its candidate and chairman of the party, Felicia Ola, highlighted the rubbish pile that Nicole Young walks through to get to the office, forced the PNM to address it. Now it's been cleaned. The people had it so for 8 years. Now they get in a bin. Campaigning, election mode, the closest thing we get into forcing these two parties to deliver is campaign mode. The Progressive Empowerment Party is going to remain in campaign mode. We're taking a small break. I'm going to give my whole party a family day internal for all the kids who have sacrificed, all the husbands and wives who had to not see their significant other, children, our parents, mothers, fathers. We're going to do a nice big family day internally, not a public one, to give every, we're giving everybody a break, having that family day, and coming back in hard.
While your parties has been able to establish itself as a political brand in this election campaign in a profound way. You basically lost all your deposits.
I don't know, we find out all of that. The voter turnout was incredibly low. So the conversation that I came in late, I don't know if you had this conversation with your previous guest. The conversation all political leaders have to have in their mind and all political parties have to have right now is why the people are not coming out of it. You could say if it is just TNM and UNC, that it is race and 50% of the 100% willing to divide itself into 1.5 people to 10 people to support a party based on race. We could say that if it is just the TNM and UNC. But with the advent of the Progressive Empowerment Party and other strong options, it shouldn't still be such a low voter.
So then why is that happening? Because, I mean, this was one of the most, in my memory, this is my, in my memory, the most vociferous campaign of any local government election I have seen. I have seen strong brand showings from yourself, the NTA, PDP, in addition to the PNM and the UNC, and several independent candidates hitting the ground. Yet, we see this low voter turnout and apathy. Why?
What is the point of
telling
this? At some point, it's become institutionalized to ridicule government and ridicule election. It benefits those who are corrupt and divisive in society, that people not involve themselves in the process, that people feel that somehow it is futile. And we all, every single one of us that is a serious political vehicle that wants to give the people representation, we have to ask ourselves introspectively, why the voter turnout is so low. I want to make one more point. Last night, Greg Robinson, senior member of our Diego Martin team, sent a voice note from Marsha Walker. Marsha Walker did through arithmetic. I am not going to disrespect anybody this morning as much as I believe this requires some political links. Marsha did some quick arithmetic and she said that the PNM got 1199. She got 1132. She got 799. I'm just averaging the numbers. And that the THC got 20 or 25, and the PEP got 252. And in her mind, she did a quick math. She said, if all of those votes had come to the UNC, she would have been the PNM. And then she went on to say, a vote for the PEP is a vote for the PNM because it didn't allow you to win. But what the UNC and their narrative peddling are failing to understand is that we brought those people out to vote for us. If we were not there, they, like the rest of the 700,000 people that said, no thanks, we're not coming out. Marsha was stuck at her 799 with or without the PEP. I'll go further. Because we gas up the country to come out and vote, the Progressive Empowerment Party campaigned so hard. But between nomination day and campaign day, the size of the party changed. And we went into this election as the PEP of June 6th. The PEP of August 15th had an entire nation going to polling stations looking to vote for a party that barely had a third of the districts nominated. So those people, and I got hundreds of messages yesterday, they voted for this one, they voted for that one, they did this against vote, they spoiled the ballot, they didn't vote at all, they put in an all of that. But the Progressive Empowerment Party's impact on the election brought people out that may have benefited her. But it is foolish in the extreme for the UNC to continue to peddle this nonsense that votes belong to them. And I will go further to say this. It's time for us to start adopting something like the United States primary model, where all of the potential candidates vying for the election fight each other to find who will be the main contender to take on the incumbent. That is something we need to consider, because we cannot continue to go forward with this misunderstanding of how politics is supposed to work, and it is muddy in the water. The UNC, and I have to agree with your last commentator, the UNC muddied the water for the election. They spent a lot of money distracting. They tried to damage us. They didn't debate us. They didn't campaign against us. They didn't raise competing issues. They just tried to damage us. In the last 3 weeks of the election, I put my party on ignore. Ignore that leader. Ignore the UNC. Ignore their attacks. We not respond. We will let them run their own, and we will continue to build our party. What we found on election day is a lot of genuine support. I am dismayed that we did not break through the stranglehold of the duopoly of race, but I am confident and encouraged that coming out of the experience of this election, the work that was done, 2025 is going to be a horse of a different color.
Well, we're out of time. We want to thank you for your contribution to our shows in the last 4 weeks and making yourself available. And wish you and your party and your supporters and your colleagues all the best. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Great. It's Phillip Alexander, political leader of the Progressive Empowerment Party. And